Yo,
what's up? This is Patrick
and this is Marco,
and in this video we're going to talk about the tale of two caches, the report cache and the data cache. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, Marco, thank you so much for taking time out of your busy day to come hang out with us. Marco, before we get into this, I know everybody knows who you are, but why don't you do a quick introduction to the world to let them know who's Marco?
Marco writes articles on Secret BI about DAX and data modeling. And so this is what I do today for a living.
Marco's been on the live stream. He's been on YouTube videos before. So Marco, you and I talked about this a while ago, this report cache and this data cache, and I decided let's do a video. So Marco, why don't you take over here and tell us what you think and explain the difference between this report cache and this data cache.
Patrick, thank you. But you know, instead of talking, let's head over to my desktop. This is a report where I have a simple table and a slicer. Whenever we interact with the report, something happens. So in order to show you what happens and in order to explain the two different caches that we have to activate the performance analyzer. You see that every action that I apply to the report is recorded here. For example, if I click to one country, Australia, you see that change the slicer is the event we have, and we have the slicer and the metrics that have been refreshed. And you see that each of the two visuals have a query that has been generated. Now I click to Canada and the same happens. So the metrics and the slicer both have something, but we already noticed that the slicer doesn't have the copy query. When I click back to Australia, notice that also this time we have the two events, but in this case, both visuals have no query. What has happened? So the idea is that if you look at the content of this slicer, the slicer has exactly the same content we had at the beginning. We only changed the selection, whereas the metrics we have in this area change the content every time I click at a different country. But when I click at Australia the second time, the result displayed was the same that was displayed before. So what is happening in this case is that there is a report cache. So the Power BI user interface knows that a certain set of filters has been applied to the report. And if the same filter is applied again, instead of sending the query again to the engine, the report can simply reuse the result of the previous query, because if you set the same set of filters, it's actually the same kind of cache. And this is the report cache.
So Marco, you're telling me it's smart enough to say, hey, you've already used this filter on the report. I don't need to issue a query. I don't need to go and get data. I can use what has already been collected, what's already in the report cache, to render my visuals. If I wanted to rerun those DAX queries, is there a way to do that inside of Power BI Desktop?
Excellent question. Now, when I do Canada and Australia, whatever I do, the new events have no query at all. But if I click refresh visuals, I scroll down, you see a refreshed visual is the events, and you see copy query again, because the report cache has been cleared. And if I click Australia, for example, you see that now the matrix has the query, because Australia was there before, but when you click refresh visuals, the report level cache is gone.
Now, Adam and I, we always talk about this data cache. Yep. When I click that refresh visuals, I saw the DAX query, so I'm assuming it's sending that DAX query back to the VertiPack engine. Is there a way for me to find out if that's hitting the cache? Is that clearing the data cache?
Let me clarify what is going on.
Okay.
I want to show you what happens when we open DAX Studio, and then I will use a schema to represent in a graphical way the two different caches that we have. So first of all, I have DAX Studio here, and you see that this all queries shows all the queries sent to the engine. So what happens? DAX Studio is connected to the analysis services engine behind Power BI and intercepts all the DAX queries the Power BI report sends to the engine. If I clear this list, this is not a cache, and just clear this list to show that I don't have anything now. If I go back to Power BI Desktop, let me clear this list. When I click refresh visuals, we have one and two queries. These two queries are exactly the same two queries you have here, one and two. This is actually the same content we have in Performance Analyzer in all queries. But now I can show the content of this query here, and I can execute this query locally in DAX Studio just to see what is the result. Because what happens is that every visual generates a new DAX query that returns a table with the result that are rendered in the report. When I run this query, in the result, you see data. And this is the same data that has been used to populate the visual. This is the result of the query, and this is what the Reaper can cache. What I want to explain is that we have actually two different caches. One is the Reaper level cache, which is the cache in Power BI in the report of the content of the result of a DAX query. Then there is another cache that works internally to the analysis services engine. So let me explain what is happening. If you remember, we have a report, and the report we designed had some data. We had a slicer with a few options. This is Power BI Desktop. Power BI is where we see the data. For each visual, generates a different DAX query. Now, these two DAX queries are sent to the analysis services engine, where we have the actual data compressed in memory and so on. Each of these two queries actually returns some data to populate the content of the visuals. Now, the first cache we analyze now is the cache that works at the Reaper level. So here, when we asked Australia, let's say that the result of the first query was stored here. Then we asked for Canada. Then we asked for Australia again. Now, the second time, the DAX query was not sent to this analysis services engine because it was retrieved from the cache. So when I return to a selection that was already requested before, we just use this local Reaper cache. So what is the other cache? The analysis services actually stores our tables with the data in memory in a compressed way. For example, the customers, the sales, and so on. The DAX query has to compute, to query the content of the data in memory. And when it does this, it actually generates internal queries. So we have the DAX query, but the DAX query actually send queries to the storage engine, and we call this query XMSQL query. These queries have another level of cache that optimizes the behavior of the analysis service engine when you have large data models with hundreds of millions of rows or more. When I go back to DAX Studio in this case, I have tools that can show me what is going on. With server timings, I can see what happens when I execute a query. So if I click run, the query has been executed, but you see in this area that there has been a single storage engine queries to return the content that we see in the result. This result has been obtained with a single XMSQL query that we can see in this line. You can see the content of the XMSQL query in this area, but this query has been returned by the cache. It means that we didn't actually query the model in memory. The engine retrieved this internal calculation from the analysis services cache.
So I see that single line, but is there any way for me to visually see if the data came from the cache or if it came from the internal data structures?
Of course. You see that we have other buttons, cache and internal, that are disabled by default because this makes it easier to see the result, because usually we want to see a single line and we are not interested in the fact that the query was in cache or not. Because usually when you try the performance of a query, you want to run in the worst possible conditions, which means I don't have any data in cache. You see that there is a button clear cache. If I click this button and I click run again, you notice that now we had a single request, you see this scan, that internally executed two internal storage engine queries. So when you remove this is the cost, 109 milliseconds. And this time, the query has been executed in 64 milliseconds because the storage engine cache can work in multiple threads. And indeed, you see this parallelism is the division between the CPU cost and the duration. We had almost two cores used to solve this query because actually I'm querying a table that is 10 million rows large. So let me restore internal. Now, you see, this is the execution that actually obtained in this intermediate step 1 million rows. But when I click run again, look at what happens. The execution is much faster. We have only 1 millisecond in the storage engine because the data was in cache. And you see that the execution is much faster.
There's two caches. There's a report cache and the data cache. And when you're trying to do baselining and benchmarking, you need to be in the worst possible condition. You need to clear both the report cache and the data cache to get a good baseline of how things are gonna perform. But if I publish the Power BI report out to the service and Adam hits the report, he chooses Canada. I hit the report, I choose Canada. My guess is there's gonna be a report cache for each one of us contained in that data. But when those queries go back to the analysis services engine, if Adam hit it first, Adam already cached that data up. So I'm gonna hit the data cache for analysis services.
This is Adam and this is Patrick. Yep. And we are representing this way two sessions we have on the cloud, PBI service. Adam is working from his PC and you are in a completely different place. But when you run these two queries, you're running over the same service. However, this is the cache for Australia. Then there is cache for Canada. As you see, the cache is local to the session. So when Patrick runs the same report, this cache is a different one. However, both Adam and Patrick are using the very same analysis services engine. And this analysis services engine is the same one. So the DAX query is sent by Adam and the DAX query sent by Patrick goes in the same place. And we had a storage engine cache on analysis services. That cache is shared across all the connections. But while this cache, the cache at the repo level could be very large, the cache that we have at the service level is limited to a smaller number of queries, which means that this cache is really important only when you have a large table and many users queries the same data at the same time.
That's amazing. Great information. All right, guys, what do you think? Tell it to caches, report cache, data cache. Make sure you clear them both if you're trying to do some effective performance testing and analyzing of the performance of your reports. If you have any questions, if you have any comments about this, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam
and Marco
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.